Yes, in the last lecture we have discussed with the least cost search. There we have seen what is controlled abstraction algorithm for the least cost search. That means, like, whenever there is a state space tree, from that state space tree, if we want to find the cost of the particular node, and that too if you are interested in the minimum cost of that particular node, then how we can find it. So that already we have discussed. Now after that we have discussed with the FIFO branch and bound. Am I right? We have discussed with the FIFO branch and bound, and there we have seen how a BFS, that is breadth first search, uses queue data structure. There actually BFS uses the queue data structure that uses the principle of first in first out. Therefore this algorithm is also known as the FIFO branch and bound. Okay, then we have seen one example, like we have seen one tree, state space tree, and with the help of FIFO branch and bound, how we can process the nodes, that also we have already discussed. So let me share the screen so that you'll be able to understand. Yes, dear student, make sure that the screen is visible to you. Is it visible? Yes, dear student, is it visible? Okay, fine. So as far as the FIFO branch and bound is concerned, we have seen one tree, that is what we can say, a state space tree. Okay, for the FIFO branch and bound, we have seen one tree. That tree is nothing but the state space tree, and in that tree what we have discussed, we have seen there is a node, root node. We can call it as a node A. Then that node A is expanded into node B, as well as node C, as well as node D, and B is further expanded into node E. That is what we have discussed, okay, in the last lecture. This is, we are talking about FIFO branch and bound. Okay, this is, we are talking about FIFO branch and bound. Now, dear student, here what is important, as you know very well, this is what FIFO branch and bound, or as far as the search is concerned, this is what breadth first search. There we have to use the queue data structure. So initially what we need to do, initially suppose this is a queue, we need to insert A into the queue. Then we will delete that A from the queue. We will delete that A from the queue. Once we delete that A from the queue, then whatever the node which are adjacent to A, we will push, not push, we will add those nodes into the queue. Okay, we'll add A, we will delete A. After that, whatever the adjacent of A, those we have to add into the queue. So adjacent of A's are B, C, D, so that we will add into the queue. Fine. After that, we have to delete first in, first out. So accordingly, we have to delete what? B we have to delete. So when we delete B, what is remain? When we delete B, so there is C and D is remain. But when we delete B, we know that adjacent of B is nothing but E. So that we have to push into the, sorry, that we have to add into the queue. Actually, we are using the term add and delete on queue, and we are using the term push and pop on the stack. So here we have to add the E. So E will be added here. After that, in the next step, again, this C will be deleted. So what is remain? D and E is remain. After that, again D will be deleted, so only E is remain, and finally we can say about empty. Okay, Q is empty. So dear student, this is what the fundamental thing, or this is what the core principle of FIFO branch and bound. Now let us discuss the algorithm. Let us discuss the algorithm for FIFO branch and bound. Let us see the algorithm for the FIFO branch and bound. So what is that algorithm for FIFO branch and bound? So here is the algorithm for the FIFO branch and bound. Here you can see the algorithm for the FIFO branch and bound. So what it says, step number 1, initialize the queue. Initialize queue. Okay, right here, queue. Okay, first of all we have to initialize the queue. Then step number 2 says that let V be the root of that tree. We will call V. This V is the, let it is the root of tree. We can call it as a capital T. Let V is the root of capital T. Fine. Then after that, third step, let the current value of V be best. Whatever the current value of V, we can call it as a best value. Current value of V, we can call it as a best value. Current value of V is nothing but the best value. Fine. Let us say current value of V is nothing but the best value. After that, in state number 4, we will insert V into Q, current root. Okay, whatever the root is there. So we will insert V into Q. We will insert V into Q. Fine. After inserting V into Q, step number 5 says that what we have to do in the step number 5, while Q is not empty, while Q is not empty, while Q is not empty, okay, while Q is not empty, what we have to do? While Q is not empty, then we have to remove the node V. So for that, we are having sub steps. While Q is not empty, so when Q is not empty, then what we have to do? We have to remove node V. Remove node V. V will be removed. Second step is nothing but for each child of V. Okay, for each child of V. So whatever the child of C, V, each child of V, for each child of V, we have to check the bound function. Whatever the number of children of V are there, so for those we have to call the bound function. We have to call the bound function. So that we will call the bound function, and again, whoever the children of V are there, those children again we will insert into the queue, and again we will update. Okay, so what does it mean? It means that whoever is the children of V, we will check whether it is best. If the children of V is best, actually we have considered the best value, V itself is the best value. But if we found that the children of V are also best, in that case we will insert the children of V into the queue, and we will update the best value as per the solution. We will update the best value as per the solution. And last step is nothing but the exit. Last step is nothing but the exit. So let me tell you, let me explain you. Right now, let us say this is what we can say about A. This is B. This is C. Okay. Then this is E. And this is what? D. Fine. Initially, we will initialize the queue. Let us say this is queue. This is what queue. We will, V is the root of the queue, root of the tree. Then we will, what we will do, we will consider the current value of V is the best. This A is the current value, and we will insert A into the queue. We will insert A into the queue. A is the current value. That is, we can call it as the best value that we will insert into the queue. Then while queue is not, while this A is not empty, A is not empty. Sure, A is having children. Who are the children of A? B and C. So let us remove A. We will remove A, and we will check who are the children of A. B and C are the children of A. So I'll add B, I'll add C. या दोघांपैकी बेस्ट कुठली येते कन्सिडर करणार विथ द हेल्प ऑफ बाउंड फंक्शन वी कॅन फाइंड आउट विच इज द बेस्ट व्हॅल्यू अँड अकॉर्डिंगली मिस कॉस्ट मिनिमम कॉस्ट कुठली आहे कुठल्या विच नोड गिव्ज द मिनिमम कॉस्ट फाईन ऑर मॅक्सिमम इट डिपेंड्स ऑन वॉट वेदर यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन मॅक्सिमम व्हॅल्यू ऑर वेदर यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन द मिनिमम व्हॅल्यू इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट 0x1 नॅपसॅक प्रॉब्लम वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन मॅक्सिमम व्हॅल्यू Okay, if we are talking about traveling salesperson problem, we are interested in the minimum value. So it depends. Fine. So accordingly, we will insert those values into the those children of A into the queue. Again, we will process them. B. Again, this will get repeat. Okay, we can call B as a root node. Again, we will check whether B is having children. Yes, B is having children. Then that we will add into the queue. Okay. Then we will remove C. And again, we will add the adjacent of C is nothing but E that we will add into the E. And depending on the best performance or depending on the best value, we will choose that and we will update that particular best value. Okay, we will update the best value. So this is what a very simple FIFO branch and bound algorithm. Got it, dear student? Got this or not? Hello, dear student. Got this? Am I audible? Yes, Naneshwari, Avadhoot, Vaishnavi. Whether you understood this? FIFO branch and bound. Okay, voice is breaking. Now it is clear. Dear student, now it is clear. Now it is clear whether my voice is audible. It is clear. Yes, dear student. Okay, fine. Okay, so let us move ahead. Let us see the next type of algorithm, and that is nothing but the least cost branch and bound. Next topic is nothing but the least cost branch and bound. Next is least cost branch and bound. Okay, so what exactly happened in least cost branch and bound? Here is what we will discuss with least cost branch and bound. Now what is there in least cost branch and bound? Like here we have seen in FIFO branch and bound, the traversal is nothing but the BFS, that is breadth first search. So here, actually, here in least cost branch and bound, there is a second type of searching, and that is nothing but the depth first search. That particular searching is nothing but the depth first search. Okay, so this is what also known as the best first search technique. Okay. Actually, here when we talk about the least cost branch and bound, So what is the algorithm for the list cost branch and bound? That also we have to understand. And while talking about the list cost branch and bound, the implementation of list cost branch and bound technique requires extracting the nodes of we need to extract the nodes of minimum or maximum value based on the problem statement. Actually here we have to use the priority queue. Okay, though here we are talking about list cost branch and bound, so here in list cost branch and bound we have to use the topic, we have to use the concept of what? Priority queue. So dear student, here we will not use the stack, though if you are in the assumption that here we will go and where we will use the stack, no, here we will not use the stack, here we will use the priority queue. How we can use the priority queue now, dear student? Here the priority queue is required as it is facilitate the removal of the minimum and maximum element. The priority queue is a max heap for maximization and it is a min heap for the minimization. Dear student, you may be remember that implementation of priority queue using heap data structure, and when we talk about the heap data structure, when we talk about the heap data structure, so there are two types of heaps. One is minimum heap and another is a maximum heap. Do you remember the data structure which we have learned, heap data structure which we have learned in the second year? So heap numbers we can sort with the help of heap. Okay, heap sort, and actually there we need to use the max heap as well as the min heap. Fine. So here we are using priority queue as far as the list cost branch and bound is concerned, and actually here we have to use the min heap and max heap. So when to use min heap? If there is a maximization problem, then we will go for max heap. If there is a minimization problem, we will go with the min heap. Here actually what happens in the list cost branch and bound algorithm? Let us take the algorithm. So as far as the algorithm is concerned, step number one is initialize the priority queue. Initialize priority queue. We have to initialize the priority queue. Second step, let V be the root of state space tree. Let V be the root of state space tree. Let V be the root of state space tree. Third step is nothing but let the current value of V be the best. Current value of V. Let the current value of V. Current value of V is the best. Current value of V is the best. Then step number four, we will insert V into the priority queue. Insert V into queue. Priority queue. Insert V into priority queue. Then step number five, repeat. What we have to repeat as far as step number five is concerned? Here repeat the following till termination. So what is those sub points? Point number one. Okay, what we have to repeat? Remove node V. We will remove node V. Second, if node V is solution node, means we can say that it is list cost. Okay, if V node is a solution node or goal node, or we can say target node. Yes, it is true. V is the solution node or V is the target node. Then report solution. Then you can return whoever is the caller of this particular function. You can return that particular solution to the caller. Fine. Hello. Now audible. Now I am audible. Dear student. Hello. Now it is clear. Or still my voice is breaking. Still my voice is breaking, or whether it is clear? Now my voice is clear.
Okay, fine. So what we are talking, about insert V into Q. First four steps are same as far as PPO branch and bound is concerned and LC branch and bound is concerned. First four steps are same. When we talk about the FIFO branch and bound, first four steps are same. Okay. First four steps are same here. Is that clear, dear student? First four steps are clear. When we talk about the list, cost, branch and bound. Fine. We will insert V into the queue. Then we will repeat. We have to remove the V. Okay. We will remove the node V. If node V is the solution node, we will report solution. Fine. Otherwise, if queue is empty, if the priority queue is empty, then no solution is possible. If queue is empty, no solution is possible. And if both the things are not there, then we can generate a node and add it to the priority queue. Then we can generate the node, and add it into the priority queue. And this is what exit step. Means, dear student, let me explain this with the help of example. If this is what a node A, this is what node B, node C, here is node D, here is node E. Fine. Now, as far as the list cost branch and bound is concerned, we will initialize the priority queue. This is what priority queue. We will insert A into the priority queue because this is the best value. Then we have to we'll insert V into the queue. Then we will remove this A from the queue. And whatever the if A itself is a solution, if root node itself gives me the solution, then I'll report the solution. If it doesn't give the solution, then I'll check that whether queue is empty. Okay. And after that, we will generate the node and add it to the priority queue. Fine. So accordingly, B and C both will be added into the priority queue. Now, dear student, you may ask one important thing. Sir, here the steps are same. Then what is the difference between the FIFO branch and bound and list cost branch and bound? In FIFO branch and bound, we are using queue data structure, whereas in LC branch and bound, we are using priority queue as a data structure. Then what is the difference between these two data structure? Can anyone is able to clarify that what is the difference between queue data structure and priority queue data structure? What is the exact difference between FIFO branch and bound and LC branch and bound? Come on, hurry up. Yes, dear student, what is the difference? Here in list cost, that is LC branch and bound, we are interested in list function. So list function is able to find the cost of the particular node. So the cost of node. So when we out, we are using priority queue. That means though it is first in, first out, but still though it follows the characteristics of first in, first out, but still there is a difference in priority queue, because in priority queue, if there are two items and both items arrive at same time, if both items are arrived at the same time, but the one, suppose item one is having highest priority and item two is having lowest priority, and both items arrived at the same time, or let us say item one is arrived, then item two is arrived, and then item three is arrived, and in that case the one item who is having highest priority, that particular item will be served first. that particular item will be served first. Though we can say we are following first in first out, but still, as far as the priority queue is concerned, the item or the node whose priority is highest, that particular highest priority node or that particular highest priority item will be served first. That is what the important difference when we talk about the list cost branch and bound using priority queue. Is that clear, dear student? Is that clear, dear student? Hello? Is that clear, dear student? The difference between queue and the priority queue. So, dear student, here is the end of our unit number 5. So what we have discussed as far as unit number 5 is concerned, so let me tell you, let me summarize what we have discussed with unit number 5. As far as unit number 5 is concerned, dear student, we have discussed with the branch and bound, that is your unit number 5. There you have discussed what is branch and bound. Okay. After that, we have seen the solution of 0x1 knapsack problem using branch and bound. That solved the 0x1 knapsack problem using LC branch and bound and FIFO branch and bound. So we discussed LC branch and bound and FIFO branch and bound. We have seen one example. After that, we have seen the traveling salesperson problem using branch and bound. We have seen what is row minimization, what is column minimization, how we can subtract it, how we can find the lower bound value with respect to the different nodes in state space tree, and how we are able to find the minimum cost and the minimum path of the given graph using traveling salesperson problem. After that, dear student, we have discussed with the terminologies which is associated with the state space tree. There we have seen E node, live node, and dead node. After dear student, we have discussed with the list cost control abstraction, algorithm for list cost that we have seen. After that, dear student, we have seen the algorithm for FIFO branch and bound. Then we have seen the algorithm for the list cost branch and bound. And then while discussing with all those things, we have discussed with the bounding function also. What is bounding? That also we have discussed. So these are the things which we have discussed so far in this particular unit, entire unit, unit number 5. So here is the end of unit number 5. Assignment, I'll upload the assignment on unit number 5 today itself. You have to submit within 7 days from today onwards. Within 7 days, you have to submit assignment number 5. I hope first 4 assignment on unit number 1 to 4, you might have started and you are submitting. The last date is nothing but the 15th. So you have to submit it before the deadline. Similarly, today I'll just upload the assignment number 5 on unit number 5, branch and bound. Okay, dear student. Already, if you remember, in one of the lecture, we have started unit number 6 as well. That is computational complexity. Under that, we have seen what are the various types of problems, that is P class problem, NP class problem, and so on, that already we have discussed. So in detail, we will also start in the next lecture. What is unit number 6? As far as this design and analysis of algorithm is concerned. Is that clear, dear student? Hello. So we will start with unit number 6. Already we have started unit number 6. If you remember that we have discussed with the P class problem, what is complexity, what are the terms which are associated with the complexity, then what is P class problem, what is NP class problem, what is NP hard, what is NP complete, what are its definition, what is deterministic algorithm, what is non-deterministic algorithm. That we have to see, that we have to discuss. In the next lecture, we will take one example of deterministic algorithm. We'll take one example of non-deterministic algorithm. There are different terminologies which are associated with the deterministic algorithm and various terminologies which are associated with the non-deterministic algorithm. Okay, what are those algorithms? That also we need to discuss in detail. So that we will discuss in detail in the next lecture. Is that clear, dear student? So if you are having any issue, feel free to ask your doubts or your issues. Mark your attendance. Yes, dear student, you mark your attendance. I'll stop here. Okay. Thank you, all of you. Thank you very much. And one more thing. Hello, dear student. On unit number 6, there will be few topics for the self-learning. So very soon, there will be few topics on the self-learning. So very soon you will get You'll get the topics of self-learning. Accordingly, you have to prepare yourself. Fine. So thank you, all of you. Thank you very much.